And then soles of our, whoops, let's see, soles of our feet together, knees out wide, starting to connect with the breath. But before we start down on our backs, or at least before I do, I'm going to ring the gong. I missed it yesterday. And again, starting to connect with the breath. Exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction, from the tops of your throats, down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your hearts to track the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. Again, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. One more time, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore, and allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual. And it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. And one deep exhale. Good job. Inhale, those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over your right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist, opening up your right obliques as you do. Again, as we do, we release toxins. Make sure that you drink lots of water after every practice. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist, opening up those left obliques and smile. It's Wednesday, we're halfway through the week. And again, it's a little cooler today than it was last week. I think that the temperature is going to be going up again, but take advantage of today if you're here in Arizona. Inhale, back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. And then grab onto your insteps, drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet, pull down with your hands, and happy baby. Again, drag those shoulders back and down as much as you can. Baby rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. And then from here, bend your knees, flex your feet, arms are out east and west, palms are down. Inhale first, exhale as your knees fall down to the left. Again, but don't touch, open up those right obliques. Inhale back to center. Exhale to the right, but don't touch. Again, working those obliques. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. Inhale to center. Exhale left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. And again, either two more or seven more, wherever you are. Exhale, left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. Inhale to center. Exhale, left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. Inhale to center. Exhale, left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. Again, you can stop here or follow us. Exhale, left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. Inhale to center. Exhale, left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. Inhale to center. Exhale, left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. Inhale to center. Exhale, left. Inhale to center. Exhale, right. One more time, inhale to center, exhale left, inhale to center, exhale right. Good job. Draw those knees in for a hug. Rock back and forth. Inhale first. And exhale, your legs down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your left side, left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale, that right knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, as you extend above you, again, drag that shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out in infinity pose again. Possibly grab on and pull your leg towards you as much as you can. Breathing in and out in infinity pose. Inhale, that right knee in. Exhale, down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your right side, right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale, that left knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you, drag that left shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out. Again, possibly grab on to your calf, drag that leg towards you. Inhale, your left knee in, exhale down to the end of the mat. Draw your knees in, place your hands behind your thighs, spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again. Allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment. Let's do three or four of these. And arrive at the tops of our mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose, crisscross applesauce. Good job. Place your hands on your knees. I'm going to fix my mat first. And then from here, place your hands on your knees. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale down onto that right elbow. Look up towards the ceiling. Again, drag that left hip back and down. Left shoulder back and down. Open up those left obliques and smile. Inhale, back to center. Exhale first. Inhale, that right arm up. Exhale, down to the left. Again, drag that right shoulder back and down. Right hip down. Open up your right obliques and smile. Inhale, back to center. And then from here, exhale first. Inhale, that right foot up on top of your left thigh. Again, we're in half lotus. Sitting up straight, crowns of our heads just above our root chakras. Inhale, both arms all the way up. And exhale, reach, 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 reach. All the way down, fingertips come down, hearts come down. Again, third eye comes down, rocking it back and forth, massaging your intuition, opening it up as you do. Again, we're also opening our shoulders, our hips, and our thighs. If this is too intense, you can always just place that right foot out in front of your left foot. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk your hands to the right, grabbing onto your right knee with your left hand. Bring that right hand back and possibly rock forward and take a bind. Again, dragging your shoulders back and down, opening your heart to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you release that right foot. Inhale that left foot up on top of your right thigh. And again, we're in half lotus, sitting up straight. Shoulders are back and down, flat backs. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, reach, 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 reach. As far as you can, fingertips come down, hearts come down. Again, in humbly bowing, half lotus. Breathing in and out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk your hands to the left, grabbing onto your left knee with your right hand. Bring that left hand back or rock forward and take a bind if this is in your practice. Again, dragging those shoulders back and down, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. And smile. Again, it's Wednesday, middle of the week. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you release that foot. And then from here, let's go ahead and move into a headstand. So find a space on a wall. Make sure that you have something underneath your head. If you're not on carpet, tuck in your shirts. Interlace your fingers, place the crowns of your heads in between your hands. Place your elbows at ear height. Push up onto your tippy toes. And again, you can just stay here if you'd like to. This is an inversion. You can also stay on your knees with the crowns of your heads on the floor as well. But you can also start walking those feet towards you as far as you can, and then kick up one leg and then the other, or both together. Again, we're in a headstand. This is allowing the circulation to come back down to our vital organs, back down to our brain. This is in your practice. Maybe flex your feet and draw them off of the wall in a balance. So you're balancing on those elbows. Breathing in and out. And then when you're ready, you can either draw those legs down together or one at a time, whichever is in your practice. But be as graceful as you can, and then place those knees down and gently come up. Good job. Let's move to the mat, placing our hands just below our shoulders. Our knees are just below our hips in table. Again, if you look between your legs, you should see your feet. Inhale that right arm all the way up. And exhale as you cross under, coming down onto that right shoulder. In thread the needle. Keep your hips squared to the front of the room. Inhale that left arm up, bend your elbow, find that right hip crease, and breathe. Opening your hearts to the sideball through the breath, and smile. Inhale, that left arm up, exhale down. Inhale, your right arm all the way up, and exhale down. Good job. Inhale, your left arm up, exhale. As you thread it under, coming down onto that left shoulder, keep your hips squared to the front of the room. Inhale, your right arm up, bend your elbow, find that left hip crease, and breathe. Again, breathing in to thread the needle, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale, that right arm up, exhale down. Inhale, that left arm all the way up, and exhale down. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and inhale your right arm straight out, just looking to see if I have enough room behind me. Left leg goes back, flex your foot just enough. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Again, thumb is up, foot is flexed. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. In sunbird. And then exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out, and wrap that right arm around, bend your knee, grab onto your ankle, and pull up into modified dancer, modified boat pose. Exhale, down. Inhale, that left arm out, right leg goes back. Again, we're in sunbird. Flex your foot, thumb is up, looking out gently beyond the mat. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Wrap that left arm around. Bend your knee, grab onto your ankle, and pull up into modified dancer, modified boat pose. Exhale, down. Then curl your toes under, sit back on your heels, and make infinity signs with your wrists. Again, opening up your wrists, opening up your toes as you do. Maybe draw those arms overhead, dragging your shoulders back and down, dragging your tailbone in, flattening your backs in the Uchita. Possibly draw those hands behind you, fingertips touch, pushing your fingertips up towards the crowns of your heads. Again, in Anjali Mudra behind your back. Opening your toes, your shoulders, your wrists, and your fingers. Rock forward on your elbows, slap out your toes, here, plant the palms of your hands into the mat. Curl your toes under, inhale first. Exhale, back to down dog. Again, maybe walking your dog if this is in your practice. Don't feel like you have to. Flattening out your backs, Ardha Mukha Svasana, downward facing dog. Again, lifting your tailbones up towards the heavens, dragging your hearts towards your thighs. This should feel really good. This is a resting position when you're up on the mat. Balasana is our resting position when you're down on the mat. Slowly come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat, flatten out your backs, draw your tailbone in, shoulders are back and down in bear pose. Step or jump up, lighter than air, inhale, halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Again, flattening out your backs, looking towards the front of the room. Exhale down to Uttanasana, standing forward fold. And again, working towards getting your legs as straight as possible, soles of your feet on the mat, maybe even lift your toes. Maybe bend your elbows, replacing the palms of our hands on the mat if this is in your practice. Again, breathing in and out in Uttanasana. Slightly bend your knees, inhale all the way up. Swan dive backward, hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices, good job. Today we're going to move into our balances and then into Trikonasana. So I'm going to move my mat back. And let's start at the tops of our mats. All four corners of our feet are growing into the mat, in Tadasana. Again, calf muscles moving inward, thighs are moving inward. Shoulders down the back, pelvis bone comes in, abdomen is in. The crowns of our heads are moving towards the heavens. And our hands are open to receive. Find your drishti or your focal point. Make sure that you gaze gently at your drishti. Don't look at anyone else. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that right tippy toe. Draw your right heel to your left ankle, to your left calf, or to your left thigh. Vrikshasana A, B, or C. Inhale those arms up overhead into Talasana or palm tree. Uttita, hands come together. And exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Draw your knee to a marching position. Flex your foot. Inhale those arms up overhead into stork. Good job. Draw your hands together in the Uttita. And exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Take a giant step back at a diagonal. We're moving into pyramid. Square your hips to the front of the room. Draw your hands behind you into Venus Mudra. Inhale first. Exhale as you humbly bow yourselves. Over that left thigh. Again, drawing your chins to your chin if you can. Allowing your arms to come towards the center of the room with gravity. Draw your hands back towards your waist. And then release. Placing your hands on either side of your foot. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Exhale, down again to pyramid. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, down. Again, this time maybe pull yourselves in if this is in your practice by grabbing onto your ankle. Inhale, halfway up. And then place that right hand on the left side of your left foot. Open up to the side wall. Again, squaring your shoulders to the side wall. Hips are squared to the front of the room. So this is reverse triangle, reverse Trikonasana. Exhale, down. Good job. Inhale, halfway up once again. Exhale down, maybe pull yourselves in. Inhale up once again. And place that left hand on the right side of your left foot. Open up to the side wall. And again, this time, this is Trikonasana, traditional Trikonasana. So we're opening both our hips and our shoulders to the side wall so that left hip comes forward, right hip back. And again, squaring your shoulders. Exhale down. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale down one last time. Inhale all the way up, swan dive backward. Hands come together. Exhale down to Atali Mudra. Good job. Inhale as you bend that left knee, coming through into a marching position. Flex your right foot, hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down. Shake it out. Good job. So we're going to do the other side. Starting in Tadasana once again. Mountain pose. Feel that mountain within you. Feel the strength of Tadasana. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that left tippy toe, gazing at your drishti. Draw your left heel to your right ankle, to your right calf, or to your right thigh. Again, in Vrikshasana A, B, or C. Inhale those arms up overhead into Talasana or Palm Tree. Utita, hands come together, and then down. Good job. Draw your knee to a marching position, flex your foot. Inhale your arms up overhead into Talasana or Palm Tree. Draw your hands together, Utita. And exhale down. Again, to Anjali Mudra. Take a giant step back on a diagonal. Again, we're moving in to pyramid. Square your hips to the front of the room. Draw your hands behind you to Venus Mudra. Inhale first, shoulders back and down, and exhale as you humbly bow yourselves. over that right thigh as far as you can, shin to shin, allowing your wrist to come towards the center of the room with gravity. Draw them back towards your waist before you release, placing your hands on either side of your foot. Inhale halfway up, look towards the front of the room, flat back. Exhale down to pyramid. Inhale halfway up. Again, look towards the front of the room, shoulders back and down. Exhale down again. Maybe draw yourselves in by grabbing onto your ankle. Inhale halfway up. And then place that left hand on the outside of your right foot. Open up to the side wall. In reverse Trikonasana. Squaring those shoulders to the side wall. Squaring your hips to the front of the room. Good job. Exhale down. Maybe pull yourselves in if you'd like to. Inhale halfway up and place that right hand on the left side of your right foot. Open up to the side wall. This time, squaring your hips to the side wall, dragging that left hip back, right hip forward. Shoulders are squared to the side wall as well. Exhale down, maybe pull yourselves in. Inhale halfway up. Exhale down. Inhale all the way up. Swan dive backward, hands come together. And exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Inhale as you bend that right knee, coming through into a marching position. Flex that left foot, hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and move up to the tops of our mats. Inhale your arms all the way up. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Take a giant step back with your left foot. Walk your right foot all the way across. Right knee down, left knee down, left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back as far as you can. Maybe take Venus Mudra. Exhale as you humbly bow yourselves. Placing that left cheek on the mat, if this is in your practice. Make sure that before you release those hands, you draw them back towards your waist. Keep your shoulders steady. Again, we're releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing on that right hip into the mat. Inhale as you walk your hands back again. Coming off on your right hip, swing your left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to your right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find your right hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice, dragging your shoulders back and down. In the Mariandrasana twist, again, opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. And smile, it's Wednesday. Inhale, back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Come up to the tops of your mats. In Malasana, in yogi squat, again, with the backs of your biceps just below your knees. Hands are in Anjali Mudra. Possibly place the palms of your hands onto the mat, rocking back and forth, finding that sweet spot, and then rolling in to Bakasana or Crow Pose, looking towards the front of the room. And again, you can stay here working on bone strength, core strength, and bone density, and arm strength, excuse me. Or you can come back with us in Malasana. Inhale from your root chakra all the way up to your crown chakra, and exhale down again. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. Place your hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Take a giant step back with your right foot. Walk your left foot all the way across. Left knee down, right knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Possibly take Venus Mudra. And exhale gently down. Coming down onto that right cheek this time. But again, you can be on your right cheek, left cheek. You can be on your elbows, on your backs, wherever you are is perfect. Opening up that left hip, releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing there. Gently draw those arms back towards your waist before you release. Inhale, as you walk your hands back, coming off on that left hip, swing your right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that left foot in and your left elbow in. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find your left hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. Shoulders back and down in the Mariandrasana twist. Inhale, back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Place the soles of your feet on the mat. Arms are out on either side. Inhale first. Exhale, inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. And then from here, take your block in hand. Place your heels just below your sit bone. Inhale as you push your hips up, placing the block underneath your sacrum on the highest, second or third levels. Again, in a supported bridge, opening up that lower back region. Possibly walk your feet forward. Maybe draw your arms overhead in a T formation or a mushroom formation. But again, don't feel like you have to. Breathing in and out. This should feel really good. Draw those arms back overhead. Walk your feet in. Inhale as you push your hips up. Release the block and exhale down. Good job. Draw those knees in for a hug. Then extend your legs. Again, either just legs straight up, flexing your feet, maybe holding onto your thighs, maybe making mudras with your fingers. Or you can also push your hips up into a shoulder stand. Walk those shoulders under as much as you can. Again, feet are in Barbie feet. By the way, we just went to see the Barbie movie last night. So I'm all in pink today. Draw those toes overhead into halasana or plow pose. And then possibly draw your knees around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And again, be gentle with yourselves. Don't feel like you have to. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, coming back down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug. Exhale, your right leg down. Inhale, your left arm up overhead. Exhale, as you push your left knee over to the right, look over your left shoulder and breathe.
And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle.
Inhale, back to center. Draw your knees in for a hug. And exhale, that left leg down. Inhale, your right arm up overhead. And exhale, as you push your right knee over to the left, look over your right shoulder and breathe. Full body twist. Inhale, back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso. Palms are up to receive. Down to ground. Starting to relax. Relax your toes. Relax your feet. Relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your fingers, relax your torso, relax your hands. Relax your wrists, relax your forearms, relax your elbows. Relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders, relax your necks. Relax your jaws, relax your cheeks, relax your foreheads. Relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. Start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed. Hands are in Anjali Mudra. Heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Wednesday. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you tomorrow. Namaste. Thank you all. I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong. It's in here with us. going to stop the recording.
And thank you all for being with me.